invitation to tender, putting together the organizational, the project, and the asset information requirements into an exchange information requirement, and that becomes the tender. That becomes the set of tender documentation. And Louis, once we've created that, what's important?
Within the platform, you can set up teams to make sure that you can assign what teams are responsible for certain sections and invite team members with certain levels of permission so that they can see certain sections that are ready for them to review. So this is an important step in the workflow to get teams invited to the tender.
And then one of the other parts of this is being able to control what people see. So being able to say which documents people have access to and being able to share only certain parts of it and following the ISO workflow of work in progress, shared and published, we can control that along with settings on the document level as well and assigning sections to specific parties as well.
Yeah, a huge thing about that is consolidating all that information in the same areas that you're building it. Instead of using another platform to communicate and process feedback, you're doing that in the same location.